He's 13-8. Good. All these things. So, okay, exactly. I'm saying he's good. Somebody mark that down. I want that in a time capsule. Chris Broussard, colon, quotation mark. I'm saying he's good, in quotation mark, on Tua Tagovailoa, because I'm saying he's not. I anticipate that after week four, when the Dolphins are 1-3, that this news is coming out of Cincinnati, where the game was played. Tyreek Hill left the locker room before the media entered. Tyreek Hill did not give commentary after a three-catch, 18-yard performance.
That San Francisco quarterback gets into the playoffs, and you realize, against Mahomes in the Super Bowl, Stafford in the NFC Championship, we have the second-best guy at the most important position. And I think that's what Miami will eventually see. It'll be Burrow or Mahomes or Lamar Jackson or Josh Allen, and you'll be saying, boy, we need a play. And we don't quite have the guy.
There isn't no way Tua's going to stiff arm Judon and then throw a 20-yard bomb to a wide receiver. It ain't going to happen.
Oh, my gosh. No! 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 No!
Term starter, though. That's the real question we want to answer here.
Oh, no. Gonna be the Dolphins' long-term starter, and guys.
Why we started with you?
If you gotta keep asking the question, eventually you're gonna land on the answer being no. If I thought Tua had the potential to develop into a top 10 to 12 quarterback in the NFL, then I would say yeah, the Dolphins are gonna continue to ride with him. But right now, guys, I got him as the 10th ranked quarterback in the AFC at best.
Whoa.
At best.
Ouch.
And Dolphins fans, don't at me in my social media.
I don't even know who you are.
Don't get at me like that, because I'm telling the truth. A hit dog will holler, and here are the receipts. Number one, you can't rely on Tua to be healthy. He's only played in 23 of the 33 possible games since he was drafted a couple of years ago. The second thing, over this two-year span he's been in the NFL, he's got the 24th ranked QBR among eligible quarterbacks that are eligible.
He's not a guy that can move this offense downfield. He's turned into sort of a dink and dunk kind of quarterback.
I mean, he's kind of a dink and dunk quarterback. He doesn't throw the football down the field.
Play in the quarter. Tagovailoa. I convert the block and wide open. Third and 10. Tua going deep. Oh, he's got Hill! He's got Hill! That is six! Tagovailoa, blocked by Armstead. Going, he's got him! He's got him! Tyreek Hill! And the Dolphins have come back! 60 yards!
Third and six. Tua looking deep. He's got a man! Touchdown! Number two for Waddle! And
Tua, end zone. Caught. Trent Sherfield, touchdown.
What a play right there. You know, Martin Emerson, he is.
I'm laughing to the bank.
That's bullshit. You know why it's bullshit? Because it's always fucking been true. If you just did your homework, it's always fucking been true. And Trey has been screaming this from the rooftops, and we try to sit here and oh, Trey doesn't know anything. I'm right 98.7% of the time, and you people just don't get it. November 7th of 2020. Not impossible, because I said it how long ago. So I don't know what you people do, why your eyeballs don't work at my level. But Tua was always going to work. He had the best Elite 11 camp I've ever seen in my life. If you go on YouTube, go look at the year that he was at the Elite 11 camp. I'm sorry, it's the greatest quarterback performance I've ever seen. You people got it wrong. You people got it wrong because you didn't do your homework. You people got it wrong because you thought his hip injury meant that he sucked because he struggled for 10 games as a rookie. I'm sorry. Look at what happens now. You get a smart play caller. You put him in the RPO stuff that he's always been good at. Bam! Dolphins are awesome. And he hasn't lost a start this year. You know what? I'm done with these people. I'm done with these people because it's just nonsense. It's just nonsense because all you had to do is just acknowledge they've always been good. Instead, you have to tit, tap, toe around the fucking corner, act like you don't know. Oh my God, here's the fucking, oh, here's five games as a rookie. I was right. You were always fucking wrong. You people just don't get it.
Is feeling the same way about Tua. Made, well, Dolphins fans aren't going to like this, but you kind of want him to be Jimmy Garoppolo, which, by the way, Jimmy Garoppolo was part of a very successful team.
No, I don't. I don't want to watch him take care of the game. No, thank you. Not what I want to watch.
Can we show the Steelers picks, please? Because these weren't
picks. He's got three picks.
There's one. Okay, now show me the next one. This one, again, these all just go down as incompletions.
Well, you're right.
But, man, they shouldn't have. Show me another one.
He's got three picks.
I understand, and he should have had three picks in this game by itself.
Every quarterback has some.
Coach,
those.
Coach.
Opening Buffalo drive. Three plays, three throws. Josh Allen tipped it incomplete. On second and 11, back to the air. Allen has a tip, digs, tipped again, and incomplete. So we're going to play a game, Tua or Hua. So Joy will ask me, little game show here, you'll ask me if I could, who I would pick for the next 3 years, because Tua's got 3 years in his contract. So for the next 3 years, who would I take and why?
Tua or Mac Jones?
Mac Jones has a healthier body than Tua. He was more accurate at Alabama, and so a little bit bigger. I think he's got a little bit better arm. I'd probably take Mac.
Tua or Zach Wilson?
It was also surprised people I would take Tua. Now, you said the next 3 years.
Yes.
I think Zach Wilson's ceiling is higher, but the Jets are a mess. And so I don't think we're going to see the best of Zach Wilson. I think we're going to see Zach Wilson for the next 3 years in a rebuild with a coach we're not sure can coach and an owner that's impetuous and impatient.
Tua or Joe Burrow?
Joe Burrow. Burrow is much more capable of throwing the ball down the field. I think Burrow's a better athlete.
Tua or Baker Mayfield?
At this point, you know, he's probably not a franchise quarterback. He's more of a bridge quarterback. Baker, though, said, I've got no regrets in Cleveland. No regrets? None? Called out the medical staff, fighting with coaches, calling out coaches. No regrets. And then I see this play right here. Now watch this, Baker. And you throw a touchdown. And instead of, now I don't like this. I'm going to tell you right now. How come you're not, what? Where are you going? Where are you going over there?
Our band is over there. Our student section's right there. And then straight back to our sideline.
What about your team?
Did you watch the rest of the game?
I watched the whole game.
You did? So you saw me celebrate with my teammates like the three touchdowns before that too?
I don't like that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You pulled the one clip of me running right there to our fans and people that traveled well to that game, first of all. And then you didn't show the rest of the clip of me going to our sideline?
No. Have to go to the sideline. You're not going to go to a hospital. Well, where are you going to go after the touchdown? You're not going to go.
Well, you're acting like I just ran away from everybody.
Well, you did, but then you came back and circled to the sideline.
This is a 5-second clip of you showing me, and then I'm off the screen right there?
I'd like you to be with your teammates.
Watch the rest of the game, I was.
Baker Mayfield's a better quarterback. He has it. Last year, he finally has a competent coach. His passer rating was 95. Say what you want about Baker Mayfield.
Tua or Carson Wentz?
Carson Wentz, a much better athlete. Bigger, stronger, faster. Before last year, Wentz had three seasons of 20-plus touchdown passes and 90-plus passer rating. Carson Wentz, Tua. Teddy had that. I think Tua's got a little better arm. Daniel Jones, he's a bigger player, faster. Now, he's got a turnover issue, but I will say this. Daniel Jones throws a beautiful deep ball.
Tua or Jared Goff?
I think Tua's situation's better for the next 3 years. So Tua will win more games and complete more passes the next 3 years. Better O-line, too.
Tua or Sam Darnold?
Come on, people. You're just trying to tease me. It's Sam Darnold. Sam's going to have a very good year. Sam's bigger, stronger. Sam is a playmaker. Tua's not a playmaker. Now, that doesn't mean he's going to win a lot of games this year, but Darnold's got – just do your homework on this. Darnold's got his best supporting cast offensively. Carolina's got elite wide receiver running back weapons. They're going to score points this year. Watch them. And he's just a bigger, stronger player.
Who do you think gets exposed more next season? Mahomes without Tyreek or Tua with Tyreek?
Skip, these guys were a perfect match for each other because they played to what the other did really, really well.
Tyreek, Mahomes and Tyreek.
Mahomes and Tyreek.
Yes.
Skip, this was a perfect match. This was McCartney and Lennon. This was Siskel and Ebert.
Let's not go to McCartney and Lennon. Yeah. We're going to get struck by lightning. Skip, we are. It's going to come right through the ceiling.
They were great together. They still did well things apart, correct? But they
were both very good apart, but they were not the same. Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
I believe these two. See, you make my point.
No, but
Tyreek is going to have to understand my days of having three or four touchdowns of 60 yards over the top. That's probably gone. I still can be effective, but it's going to have to be a lot more catch and run near the line of scrimmage, as opposed to Skip 25 yards down the field and then Tyreek takes off.
I believe both these quarterbacks are about to get exposed to different degrees. Mahomes, I'll say a little bit, but significant bit, and Tua a whole lot. It's going to be career threatening for Tua.
Yeah.
Because all of a sudden he's on the hottest seat in the National Football
League. Of any player.
Thank you guys for watching today's featured presentation on the Vendetta Sports Media YouTube channel. This was only a drop in the bucket of all of the Tua receipts, all the bad takes on Tua Tagovailoa that exist out there. This is only a minuscule amount, a small percentage of what is actually out there. I just wanted to do this video because it's something I've been wanting to do for a while now. I've been wanting to make it just so that way I could be like, screw you to everyone that has doubted Tua. He has been that guy from day one. He needed time to recover and he just needed a little bit of help to unlock the true potential that has always been there that we saw at Alabama. If you want to see some more horrific Tua takes, description below, there will be a link to the Dolphins Receipts Twitter page. We're not affiliated with them in any way. I just think it's a funny Twitter account that keeps track of all the really bad Tua and in general Dolphins takes, but specifically Tua takes. So that way people that try to backtrack during the season can't get away with that. That doesn't mean they can't repent. Doesn't mean they can't repent. Just doesn't mean that they're going to get away scot-free. But hey, if you are a Dolphins fan and you're looking for a news outlet that, for the most part, I would say, at least with myself and our boss, Trey Daubert, has sane takes on Tua, and as well as a Dolphins fan like myself, if you are a Dolphins fan and looking for that, then go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel so that way we could pump out some more Miami Dolphins content for you guys. And if you enjoyed the video and you do decide to subscribe to the channel, go ahead and hit the like button on this video, help it with the algorithm a little bit, and then go ahead and hit the notification bell so you could be notified whenever a new video on the channel drops. Most of the time I post my reactions, positive and negative, to games, Dolphins games on Sundays. I've missed a few weeks here and there, but hopefully I'll be able to keep up with that for the remainder of the season. Anyway, guys, again, thank you so much. See you next time.